Hi everyone, thank you so much for stopping by my YouTube channel. In today's video, we're diving into part two of our series where I'll be showing you how to create an expense tracker using the new table feature in Google Sheets. So let's get started. We'll start from scratch by adding a new blank sheet. The next thing I'm going to do is import my expenses that I downloaded as a CSV file from my credit card statement. To import a file, go to File, Import, Upload, Browse, grab CSV file, Open. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add it directly in the sheet by clicking on this option to replace current sheet. So select that, import data. Here is a list of my expenses from January all the way through July. The first thing I want to do is to change this from a negative number to just a number. And to keep things very simple, I will remove the negative by using Command F, put the dash there, click on this More Options, replace with nothing and do replace all. Before I add a table, I'm going to make some formatting changes. What we're going to do now is convert this data into a table. Just make sure you're clicked anywhere within the data. Go to Format and click on Convert to Table. Click on that and that's it. All right, I'll start by renaming this table and then I'm going to change the font style back to my preferred font. And then I'll just go around and play around with some of the formatting. So what I did was I changed the color of the row using the color fill option to change the color and the color of the text. And I removed the grid lines around the table and I added in some rows and columns. The next step would be to assign the column type. So right now they're not assigned to anything. So click on this arrow, edit column type, change this to dates. Do the same for this and description, edit column type, text, category, edit column type, drop down, and it automatically pulls all of these options into the drop down. And now I can go to advanced options and change it to arrow. And of course, if I want to change the colors, I could also change them here as well. So assign the different categories, different colors, click done. This is another column that probably should be a drop down. So do the same, advanced option, done. And amount, change this to number, currency. And then for memo, change this to text. Now, because we don't have any data in memo, I will go ahead and click on show placeholders. So it looks like this. Next, I want to sort this data by clicking on the arrow, sort from A to Z. And now I have it from January all the way through June. So far, so good. Now I want to add some graphs here to make sense of the information here. So one thing with Google Sheets is that if you have the row frozen, you cannot add graphs above this. And I do want to add graphs. So I'm going to unfreeze this by moving the line back to the top. Next, I'm going to add the total expenses, merge these two cells, call this total expenses, copy this and paste it, and call this average expenses. And I'll merge this two and merge this two. For the total expenses, we're going to use a simple sum and then add this range. All I'm doing is just dragging it a little bit just to get started by capturing that column and remove the 22, hit tab, and it captures everything in that column. For the average expenses, what we want is to divide the total expenses by 6 months, but we want this done automatically. I wanted to show you behind the scenes on how to generate formulas. This would be helpful for you if you don't know a lot about Google Sheets formulas, or you get stuck in the process of coming up with a complicated formula. You can describe what you're trying to do in your AI assistant. So here's an example of that situation. I described what I was trying to do, which was I wanted to create an average of my expenses per month. Using the general average formula wouldn't work. What I wanted was a more dynamic formula that would automatically update when I add more data. So I added that extra information and it created this formula for me. Go ahead and pause the video and then you can copy the formula. If you are a member of my Patreon, you will have access to the template, which of course has all the formulas that I've used. All right, so I'm going to copy the code here. And here's where I'm going to paste the formula. Okay, if you divide this number by 6, you should get this number. Now, what happens if I add a fictional amount? I'm going to add a row below and I'm going to add a date in July. So let's say July 9th and 10th, and just add some information. Let's see what happens above. As you can see, the total changes and the average does change. The formula works as it should and it is dynamic. Next, we're going to add this graph. This graph shows us our expenses per month, January through July, we can see the total amount we've spent per month. So to do this, we're going to use the transaction date. I'll select just a part of this column and also select a part of this column. So I'm using Control to select both columns at the same time. And then go all the way up to Insert Charts. Before I make any further changes, I will change the range. So I selected only to 23, but I do want it to select the entire column. So I'll remove the number after A and after F. So right now it has selected the entire column A and the entire column F. Now I'm going to change this to a line graph, this one specifically. And then I'm going to choose aggregate just to make sure that it sums up all that amount. Okay. And here's what it looks like. I will delete this and this just to create more space and adjust the formatting here. Remove the background and the border. So right now it shows different dates. I wanted to actually show months here. So I'm going to change this from dates to months. I'm selecting the entire column, format, number, custom date and time. And I only wanted to say month. So I have one that says August, just a month. If you don't have one that has just a month, delete the ones that you don't need. Okay. So I'm just deleting the year and the date, and this is month, and we'll just have it say the full month name. Okay. Click apply. And this is what it's looking like. So I'm just going to realign that to the left. And now this is what it looks like. And you can double check this to make sure it's correct. Here's January, the entire amounts for January. So right down here, you can see it gives us the sum, which is 1202. And if I hover around here, it's 1202. So that works as it's supposed to. Finally, we're going to add this donut chart right here. The donut chart is based on a category. So we want to see the category that we're spending the most amount of money. By the way, I do have payments that's showing up as transactions. So I will delete those. To do this, click on the arrow filter column. And now I'm going to clear all and type payments. All right, so this shows up, select that, click OK. So I have a bunch of payments and I'm going to delete all of these transactions, delete them and go back to the filter, select all, click OK. All right, so now the payments are gone and this is a better reflection of the expenses. So very important, if you're pulling the information directly from your credit card and it's adding your payments, make sure you delete that first. And then now I'm going to add the category. To add the donut chart, select the column, and I'm not selecting everything, just a few, because I can adjust them after I insert the charts. Click on Insert Charts. And before I do anything else, remove 19. So it selects everything all the way down and change this to the chart. And then go to Customize. I will move the background and the border and go to pie chart and change the donut hole to 75. Okay. It's not capturing some of them. The date range is not correct. So I'm going to go back and make sure the entire range is selected again and make sure aggregate is checked if it doesn't check automatically for you. All right. So this looks much better. Okay. So now I have all of my categories showing up here. And as you can see, my largest category is food and drink, which is about 41% of my expenses. The next being groceries, travel, bill and utilities. In Spain, my bills and utilities are automatically pulled from my bank account. So this is not a true reflection of that. What's nice about this is in addition to viewing the data just like this, I can actually filter by whatever category I want. So if I wanted to see my expenses from January through June for a specific category, let's say food and drink, I can click on category, click on that arrow, filter column, clear all, click on food and drink, and it shows only my expenses for food and drink here, as well as updating the graph. This part will not update, but the graphs would. So here you can see for my expenses in January, I spent about $200, went all the way down in April because I was traveling, and then back up in May and down in June. And now the graph only shows you the expenses for that specific category. To bring it back up, select all and click OK. Another nice thing about the table is that if you click on these views right here, you can create a group view and a filter view. First, I'll show you what a group view looks like. So you can create a group view from each column within the table. We'll start with a category because that makes the most sense. If I click on that, you can see that it groups the expenses for each category. So all of the bills and utilities show up here, food and entertainment, groceries, shopping, and travel. Okay, so this might be a nice one to save. If you look up here, it says temporary group category. You can save this view and I can say category and save. I can close it out. Okay, so it goes back to normal. Every time I want to see this, I don't have to filter again. All I have to do is click on this and click on category and it goes right there. If you have a certain way you want to view your data every single month, create that view and save it. The next one I want to show you is filter, and this works almost the same way, meaning that you can select whatever category you want. So let's say for this, I don't want to see travel. So I want to see just my basic expenses for the month. Click on that. So now it's showing everything but travel. And then I can save view and name this whatever I want. Click and save and I can close it out. Okay, and it's gone. Remove the filter. And then I can come back, click on the icon and click on typical expenses. And it filters it out and I can see exactly what I want to see within the graphs based on that filter. So those are two additional things that make it so much easier using the table view. All right, so before I wrap up this tutorial, I want to show you what to do when the next month comes in. So let's say we're at the end of July. You want to add in the information. You don't have to create everything from scratch. I'm going to go all the way down. Let's add 20 new slots for July, okay? So I do want to point out that there is a flaw with this formula. It is taking into account the empty cells. This will no longer be accurate until we add the information in for July and remove the empty rows. But I will update the formula and I will have it available so that you can go ahead and use that formula instead. But let me illustrate how you will add your additional information. So go to File. Okay, we're going to import some more data now. Import. Just like we did before, just grab the additional information, insert new sheet, import data. Now we have additional data for the month of July. Copy the entry for July and just paste it there, okay? And then I'm gonna remove this additional rows, okay, because we don't need it, so that the formula does work as it should. Copy the formatting here. So everything is fine, except for the fact that we have some additional categories, okay? So we can add those categories by clicking on the edit button. And I'll just add office and shipping, merchandise inventory, and professional services. Okay, and click done. Okay, so now all those error messages have disappeared. The graph has been updated automatically. All right, so I made changes to the formula to make sure that it works regardless of if you have rows at the bottom or not. So just to simplify things, what I did was I used account unique filter, okay, to filter out the unique number of months in this column. I divided the total value by the count. So this would count how many months within this date range. And then the average would be to divide the total expenses by the number of months here. If we go all the way down here, you can see that we have July. If I were to add August, for example, as you can see, the amount here is lower because it's dividing this amount by 7. Okay, if I take August out, it goes back up. Okay, and even with the rows, if I would add additional rows here, it doesn't affect the amount here. All right, so I hope this was helpful. Like I said before, if you are a Patreon member, you will have access to this template as well as the formulas. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Take care.